Okay, come on, girls. Just the girls, not the boys now. Girls?
Yeah?
Yeah, can you come? Let's go out this way.
Mommy, go with Uncle. Go with Aunt, looking at the camera. What's your name?
Sylvia.
Blessed wedding day. And I wish them all the happiness they deserve and everything they wish in their heart. And I pray that God will grant them all their heart and desire. For today, they're very special boy, and they deserve everything that you know they need in life.
Today is their day. And I wish them many, many happy and happy marriage. Even you know, they've been living happily, but and let God protect, you know, their marriage.
Wish them God guidance and protection throughout the day. Today is their day. And I wish them happy married life. Today is a new life in their marriage. And I wish God will continue to lead them and bless them.
I can't see anybody else looking at me. is Ekwenegbuchi. I'm the son of Elizabeth. I'm coming from Germany. I'm home living here. I'm very, very glad to be in this wedding today. She's my mom, and she made me whatever I am today. And I'm going to prove to her that she's my mom. And I see you later, man.
I'm very happy today for my auntie's wedding and to be the chief bridesmaid. And I'm wishing everybody happy. And where we should have come from anywhere, I'm wishing them happy journey. And God bless them as they're arriving and they're going in peace in their home. And I wish this opportunity to congratulate my auntie for making today to be a great day for her. And all of us are very happy. Thank you very much.
But why don't you use the other one instead of that?
This one has meaning.
This one.
Yeah, that one is better.
Let me see. No.
This one.
That will not fit.
It will fit. I saw the hairdresser. If it doesn't fit, I'm coming back.
No. No way. No, madam.
No.
Is that your husband? How can you stand and watch the bride? Is that wrong?
They've been washing themselves for a while.
Marriage life. More kids.
Tonight they make twins tonight.
You'll be seeing a lot of
people. You won't know. It is like the married woman. Come on, when I'm married, if I'm not tired, well, like Yoruba,
I am okay. Madam, can I finish with your makeup?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, can I have
your bad gloves. I found some gloves above.
Okay, so what you need now is just your gloves and your belt. Okay, we can have those on, please. Oh no, tell someone to go and look for it instead of me. I'm having a shop of service.
Thank you. I call thee gladly, God's prayer. As we said, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned to my own fault, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. And I ask that you may have forgiven me for your indulgence and grace, and teach my brothers and sisters to pray for me to the Lord of our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayers. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty God, hear our prayers for Anthony and Elizabeth, who have come here today to be invited to the sacrament of marriage. Increase their faith in you and each other, and do them bless your church. We ask you this for the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns
by day, nor the moon by night. Response. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. Response. The Lord will keep you going out and you are coming in from his hand, from this time on and forevermore. Response.
For the husband, he is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, the body of which he is the Savior. Just as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, in order to make her holy by cleansing her with the washing of water by the word, so as to present the church may be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as they do their own body. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hates his own body, but he nourishes and tenderly cares for it, just as Christ does for the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I am applying it to Christ and the church. Each of you, however, should love his wife as himself, and the wife should respect her husband. This is the word of the Lord. Gospel acclamation.
There were six stone water jars standing there, meant for the ablutions that are customary among the Jews. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this. The steward tasted the water, and it had turned into wine. Having no idea where it came from, only the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first, and keep the cheaper sort till the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine till now." Taken in hand, he let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
What is the context of that first miracle? It is a miracle. harmonizing this relationship, not a temporary relationship. Like God's own love for us, it is constant and it is unbreakable. Our Catholic understanding of marriage is that when a marriage has been contracted, when it is something of great need, it's something which we come to do with tremendous respect. There are so many pressures in our society, particularly here in a place like London in these days. It is hard to be faithful in marriage. It is hard to attribute to one another that love, that faithfulness which God asks of us. The pressures around us are such that very few people have this understanding of marriage. So many So many people allow their relationships to break down and fall apart. And yet we as Catholic Christians have a vision to offer our society. On our own, it is difficult. But with God's grace, everything becomes possible. And that really is the meaning of what is happening today. We are in the night, still and quiet. Let's close our eyes. Let's remember we're in the presence of God, our loving Father. And let's ask him to pour out his fullest grace and blessing upon Anthony and upon Elizabeth and all that they are about to do. All to stand. Of the Church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. In the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Anthony and Elizabeth, I shall now ask you if you freely undertake the obligations of marriage and to state there is no legal impediment to your marriage. Are you ready, freely and without reservation, to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Are you ready? Are you ready to love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I do.
Are you ready to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his Church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, declare your consent before God and his Church. will you take Elizabeth here present for your lawful wife, according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I will.
Elizabeth, will you take Anthony here present for your lawful husband, according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I will. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. This ring,
take this ring
as a sign of my love, and my fidelity, in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Now we sit while I prepare the altar.